When you're selling a product or service online, you're probably going to want to share your files or have some sort of files that you want to give out and give access to your customers. But where do you store them? Let's find out. Hey everyone, Eva from Traveling Entrepreneurs here. I recently received an email from someone asking where we host our documents for people to access who buy them from us. So this question has two answers. There's two specific places that we use, and I would love to hear in the comments below what other services you would recommend. So there's two reasons why we would be sharing files. So the first reason is if they're huge files that we're sharing with, for example, developers or designers, and we share these files through Dropbox because it's easy, it's free to an extent unless you have a lot of files, and it can be accessed by only the people that you're giving access to, so it's quite private. And so it's great. However, some online marketers we've noticed are using Dropbox as a way to deliver their bonuses or products to customers, and we use a different service for this, and I'll talk about what it is in a second. But the reason why you shouldn't use Dropbox when you are delivering products to customers is because Dropbox will notice if there is a huge amount of people from many different countries trying to access this file, and it'll just block it. So the only person that will be able to see this file is you if you uploaded it, but other than that, people will just be seeing like a page not found, or sorry, this file isn't shared here, or something like that. And this is a really big one because customers do start to get upset, and it really does suck when people have paid for something or they think that they're getting access to something and then you send them to a Dropbox link and they can't see it. So that's the reason why we use Dropbox and how we use it. So we only use Dropbox within our team when we know only a couple of people are going to be viewing it. But in order to actually deliver products and services and downloads to people, we tend to use Amazon S3. Now, I know that there are many other uses for Amazon S3, but we have the paid option for Amazon S3 where we just host all of our bonuses, products, anything that needs to be downloaded by people that have bought it or are supposed to have access to it. And Amazon S3 gives us a URL which we can then share and pass on to people in order to access it, and they can actually download it from the source. So it means that people aren't being directed to like an Amazon S3 page where there's a button that says, hey, download this here now. It's the file. So when you follow that URL, it's the file right there. In the past, we have tried to host some of our products on our server, but sometimes it gets quite hard to manage those different files, and Amazon S3 just gives a really cool place to host everything that we need. You can create different types of buckets for your different sorts of files, and you can make it public or private. So for example, if you have a product that everyone who needs access to it has access, you can just make the URL private so that no one else will be able to see your file if they follow that URL, which is quite cool. So it's very good. I'm interested to know what other file sharing options you're using, so please comment down below. And if this was of interest, please subscribe to this channel, and hopefully I'll see you in other videos. See you later.